Welcome to the lecture about robustness of complex networks. My name is Piet van Miegem and I am a professor at the Delft University of Technology. This lecture consists of two parts. In the first part, we will introduce the phenomenon of robustness in complex networks. In the second part, we will elaborate on how to analyze robust networks and how to measure robustness. Networks are everywhere. Indeed. Here we see a network of a protein, a human brain, a food network, a genetic regulatory network, a network of financial institutions, the Dutch optical network, a US air transportation network, the US power grid, a part of the US internet. All these examples overwhelmingly show that our society depends more strongly than ever before on networks. However, this increasing dependence on networks makes us vulnerable against failures in networks. A network failure can have a huge impact. Here is a dramatization. This video shows cascading effects in a power grid. The system that fails causes an overload in neighboring systems, and as a consequence, these neighboring systems also fail. As an epidemic, the failures spread over the network and eventually result in a total blackout. The whole network operation collapses. As we've seen in this video, failures in networks have a huge impact. This high impact in network failures motivates us to design networks in a robust way. But what is precisely network robustness? Before answering this question, let us first find out what we consider as being robust. Is a car that withstands accidents while saving the passenger's life considered as robust? The answer is yes, because the passenger survived the accident. Do we consider a house that is destroyed by a typhoon as robust? The answer here is no. Because a robust house should not fall apart. Finally, we pose the $1 million question. What is a robust network? The curious point is that a simple answer of whether a network is robust or not is not easy to give. In other words, we need to define what we mean by a robust network. Addressing this question is the main focus of the research on network robustness. In order to define network robustness, we should take a closer look at the network itself and analyze it. In the next part, we will analyze the network by applying graph theory. As we will see, graph theory allows us to define properties of a network that can be computed. Graph theory is a scientific discipline that allows us to quantify network robustness. Ultimately, we like to express the robustness of networks by one number. See you at the next part.